Hello everyone. So today we are going to learn the new thing, that is learning rule and learning law in neural network. That is, when we say that artificial neural network is being able to learn itself, then we need to have defined certain rules and laws how this particular neural network is going to learn on its own. So there are certain algorithms and training algorithms which are designed and has certain rules which are being defined by certain scientists who have initiated this particular learning laws. So let's start with this. First of all, we need to understand what is this learning rule is. Basically, learning rule is a procedure when we say that we need to modify the weights and biases of a network. Now, elaborating on this particular term, that is, what is this modifying of weights? Earlier also, I have explained it that whenever we give an input, we get an output, and this particular output is being compared with the expected output. The comparison is being done. The difference between the two is called as the error generated. Now, error generated means that the expected output is not equal to the computed output. So that means there is some problem and we need to do some different thing in the network so that we get the new output which is equal to the expected output. So what we can do is there are only two parameters which is getting in the unit, that is, one is the input parameters and second one is the weight that is defined by the W. Now input we cannot change, but what we can change is we can change the weights. So for the next iteration, what we are going to do is we are going to change the weights according to certain rules and laws, and we are going to again follow the procedure of activation function and getting the final output. And then again, the expected output is compared with the computed output. And again, the same iteration is done again and again. Till up till what time? Up till we get the error which is approximately equal to zero. So this is what the adjustment of or modifying of the weights and biases of network is done. So this procedure is also called as learning rule for perceptron architecture, in which we call it as training algorithm. In next lecture, we are going to learn about the perceptron architecture. Now, what is the basic purpose of this learning rule? The basic purpose of this learning rule is to train the network to perform a specific task. You know, it can be anything. It can be if we are going to design a game in which there is a player and it is playing as a computer, it is playing and there is one more player. So computer will learn on its own and learn from its mistakes and will do better and better in the coming time. So this is the basic purpose of learning rule. Now, learning and training. During learning phase, what it is? Learning phase, it is based on recurrent networks. Now, what is recurrent networks? Just a review back of recurrent networks, which we have already done in earlier topics. Recurrent networks is the one in which we get the output and we feed it again into the input with certain changes because we have not got the actual output. So a recurrent network feeds its inputs through the network, including feeding data back from the outputs to the input. That means there is a feedback loop. Feedback loop, we all know, that is from output we are feeding it again in the input with certain changes. Now this process is repeated until the values of the outputs do not change. That means we are going to do it until we get either every time we get the same output in one or two iterations, or we are going to reduce the error. Whatever the status, we call this particular status is called as the equilibrium or the stability. So this is the main and the very important point in this particular learning phase or training phase. Now recurrent networks are used and these are trained with the help of BPN, that is called as backpropagation algorithm. In this method, at each step, the activation of the output is compared with the desired activation and errors are propagated backward through the network. This I already told you. Once this training process is completed, the network becomes capable of performing a sequence of actions. That means once we are done with the training, that means that particular network is capable enough to perform a specific task or a sequence of tasks, which it was designed or trained for. Now, there is a learning law. What is the learning law? The learning law says that the teacher specifies, as in, supervised learning we have done, that there is a teacher, and when I say teacher, teacher means the expected output is present. So the teacher specifies the desired output for a given input. That means if I say that, see, 2 plus 2 is always 4. So the inputs are 2 and 2. I have to add this. I have to make the add operation. And the final output, desired output, is 4. Now the network will learn through the previous experiences and with the formulation of rules that it has to do the addition on a specific basis. Network calculates what it thinks the output should be. So one is the desired output, the other one is the calculated output or the computed output. Network changes its weight in proportion to the error between the desired and the calculated results. That is what I already told you earlier. That is, what we are going to do is the network is going to change the weight on the basis of the error. And how we calculate the error is the difference between the desired and the calculated result. So this is the weight we are going to calculate. That is, if this Wij is when the node I is connected to the node j, and the connected W is the weight. So this is equal to alpha multiplied by teacher I minus output I multiplied by the input j. When I say teacher I or output I, in different books, in different PPTs, in different platforms, you can see different abbreviations for these. Somewhere you can see for teacher the expected output, and this particular output is termed as the actual output or computed output. So these are the different terminologies we are using for this. Basically, this is the error, teacher minus output. Yani expected output means computed minus computed output. The difference between the two is the error multiplied by the input j, where alpha is what? Alpha is the learning rate which is being defined. I told you teacher I and output I minus output I is the error term, and input j is what? It is the activation input here. So whenever we are going to adjust the weight, that means we'll get new weight with the help of the earlier weight, plus there is some delta, we can say difference between the Wij, or we are adding certain amount so that new Wij is different from the earlier Wij. So this is called as the delta rule in learning law. Further, we have perceptron convergence theorem. Perceptron convergence theorem is again defined on delta rule. That is, if a set of input-output pairs are learnable or representable, the delta rule will find the necessary weights. How it is going to find the necessary weights? With a finite number of steps or independent of initial weights. That means not necessary, the weights will be the same as it was in initial terms. It is going to change again and again. And these particular single layer perceptron can only learn linearly separable concepts. This we are going to define in the next session. Now, what is the learning process for perceptron? How we are going to learn in perceptron is, initially we are going to assign the weights. These weights are assigned randomly. It can be between -0.52 and +0.5. Training data is presented to perceptron, and the output is observed. If output is incorrect, the weights are adjusted accordingly using the following formula, which I'm going to tell you now. That is new Wi, which is going to be calculated with the help of Wi, that is the earlier Wi. This is the new Wi I'm going to calculate, and this is the old Wi plus Ai, A multiplied by Xi multiplied by E, where where E is the error produced and A is what? A is the learning parameter. Somewhere it is also defined as the alpha. A is the learning parameter, which is lying between minus 1 to 1. Between minus 1 to 1. This is the learning rate. So whenever A is defined as 0, the output is correct. That means whenever the output is correct, A is defined as 0. And whenever the output is too low, it is positive. And whenever the output is too high, this is negative. Once the modification to weights has taken place, the next piece of training data is used in the same way. That means we are going to use the training set of data again in the same way. When this particular training has been applied completely, this is done up till we get the weights as correct or we get the error as equal to or approximately equal to zero, because it is never equal to zero. Now, whenever this particular iteration is complete, that means adjustment of weight, comparing the output again and getting the error and adjusting the weight. This particular one iteration is called as epoch. This is epoch, E-P-O-C-H. Now, how do we choose or define the learning rate? This learning rate is defined here as with the help of, you know, denoted by eta. The right value of eta depends on application. When I say on the application, that means the type of problem we are going to solve. The values will always be between 0.1 to 0.9, which have been used in many applications. And heuristic approaches are being used for, you know, this adaptation of this learning rate. We are going to also learn how this 0.1 being affected and how the 0.9 is affected in different problems. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.